Hello, and welcome back to Dungeons 3.
The Hungry, Hungry Ogre. What was it with the perverted evil in those ships, anyway? Why did it always destroy them instead of saving them for another day? As may be, the legendary evil's army once again stood on the coast, wanting to set sail. But this time, for the not-quite-so-free cities. But, as I said, it needed a ship to do so. Fortunately, the harbor town of Lotsawinter was not far off, and luckily, there was an ally in the area.
Okay, complete it. In more than 40 troops at the same time, and the ogre that must not fall. Horde Titan unit with loads of life damage that does lots of possesses the Armageddon skill. Oh, interesting. Okay. Let's see what this is all about. We gotta kill some things. Do 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 do.
The gruesome evil's army once again stood on the coast of the Western Kingdoms. There, off the coast, lay the not-quite-so-free cities, a place of indecent wealth. In the planned march on the capital, there was no way these cities could be left standing, as otherwise they would attack the tactical evil from behind. To get there, it needed a ship. Again, we've been here before. Since the capable evil's creatures were still incapable of producing anything that floated, they had to borrow them from the natives. Nearby lay the harbor town of Lotsawinter, home to many famous heroes and a famous seafaring town. Unfortunately, Lotsawinter was extremely well guarded and a meeting place for extremely experienced, not to say high-level heroes. The prepared-to-make-sacrifices evil's miserable creatures wouldn't stand a chance here.
Then why are we here? That doesn't make any sense.
Easy there. However, a mighty creature was camped nearby, an ogre. Its fighting prowess would allow it to meet Lotsawinter's defenders head on. But first of all, the creature had to be persuaded to join the forces of evil.
No problem. I'll just promise him a beating if he doesn't get a move on.
Interesting idea, but I did just say that he's really powerful, didn't I? He'd mop the floor with everything we could muster against him.
Well, let's have a look at him first, then. Talk first, fight later.
Ooh, okay, so we gotta do this. We do that. Bam. Thank you. Improve. And then we go two.
Leave me. Time to take out the trash.
Lots of Winter's heroes were somewhat underemployed and always on the lookout for treasures and problems. Accordingly, the not-so-secret evil creatures were soon spotted, and a group of adventurers immediately set out to beat the stuffing out of these walking experience points.
Yeah, just let them come. Tear their heads off, bite their fingernails.
Oh my god, they're strong.
Enemies have entered the dungeon.
Ah. Okay, so here is this area. Ah, don't have enough money.
It's payday.
Okay, we need another Naga. Another goblin. Fireball!
To process all that beer, they also have an oversized bladder, which is why ogres are often used as firefighters. Yuck, just the thought makes my toenails curl.
Okay. All right. Thank you. Let me get that. Oh. This one will be the crypt.
Enemies have entered the dungeon.
Ouch.
Okay. Let's just cut that down there like that. And then
the drunken evil had built another brewing kettle. A fabulous decision. One which would surely benefit the Horde's alcoholics. It's payday.
Oh, if we give that to the ogre? So... a hole, and then we're not gonna worry about that. And this is gonna need more gold.
Your little snots have dug out a room. Spiders have spread throughout the underground. heroes are on their way to one of your islands of evilness.
Evil is unstoppable!
From the book, Ogres for Dummies. Ogres are really heavy drinkers. Their beer consumption is legendary. Once, two ogres got into a drinking contest and consumed the year supply of an entire dwarven kingdom in just one day.
Evil will triumph.
Okay, prison. And then this is the prison. Mana. Realistically, we want to go like that. And then I want to do this. I want to do that.
Absolute Evil's little snots had dug out a new room.
I think I know what I want to do here. There we go.
It's payday.
Oh, we lost one to you. Get about you.
The bustling evil had discovered a room in the underground.
Oh. Let's go to the Yogi now.
You hear that grinding sound? That's a giant worm eating its way through the underground.
Ah, balls.
Having a look around Evil's army had reached the ogre.
Hey, I am ogre.
Obviously, this creature wouldn't be winning any intelligence contests.
Me happy help you. Mushing heroes fun. But me little thirsty. Before me start, should drink something.
Of course, it wouldn't be that easy. A large quantity of beer would first have to be delivered to the ogre in order to convince him to help out. With a groan, the brewmaster Evil set to work.
Okay, you nasty little creatures, you heard the word. Time to brew some beer. Move! Hit those brewing kettles. I want to smell barley instead of mold down here. Okay, ogre, we brought you your beer. Now it's time. Wait a minute, where did the beer go? Did you already? And hey, where the hell do you think you're going? Stay where you are. We have a city to attack.
Beer make ogre hungry. Ogre get quick snack.
The ogre greedily staggered towards a small nearby farm. The sheep we heard bleating happily, which quickly turned into a panicked bleating as the sheep saw the ogre approach.
Okay, this is actually quite interesting. Now we should level up you a little bit.
So incredibly strong.
Do we get any control of the ogre? Okay.
Yummy! Tasty sheep!
The ogre decimated the sheep instead of attacking Noxawinter. It was obvious that Talia was unable to get this beast under control, much to the impatient Evil's displeasure.
What? Why is it now my problem when that stupid meatbag gets distracted by a couple of sheep?
Well, I'm just the narrator, not the General of Evil. Anyway, there was a repulsively good town very close by. It could perhaps be brought closer to Evil in the meantime.
Fine. Let's take care of it. Get out of there, twist their arms, smear finger paint in their eyes.
Ogre now, fool!
Wow! How many did you eat there, greedy guts?
Well, one sheep, two sheep, three sheep, four.
Oh, crap.
And now he's taking a nap. My goodness, my grandchildren will be doing the narration by the time he attacks the town. Anyway. Seeing as how ogres were hardcore alcoholics, one could assume that one or two or 20 or so beers would wake him up. With a heartfelt groan, the beer brewing Evil went back to work. It's payday.
access to you.
Enemies have entered the dungeon. Lost no time in delivering the beer to the ogre.
Fireball! Okay. This gets extended. We do this. Okay, and then everyone's here.
Cancel the leftovers for the lepers.
And again, the ogre was supplied with a truly absurd amount of beer.
Okay. In just a few seconds. Well, I should probably actually end the episode here, so I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, let me know down in the comments below. Otherwise, hit the subscribe button, spin all the notification bell to keep up to date, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye bye.